Modi government has declared that almost 24 Balbisita undertakings will be privatized.
It is being now given in a throwaway price.
இந்த ஓடக்கூடிய குதிரையைத்தான் இந்த பாஜக அரசு தனியாருக்கு விட்டுவிட தாரை வார்க்க துடிக்கிறது.
Now the government of India is proposing that this 15,000 crores worth of a Balbisita undertaking, a public asset, is being going to be offered to some multinational or Indian corporate companies on a throwaway prices. But we understand that Jindal, who is a leading market player, is very much interested. Last time during Vajpayee government also proposed a divestment of Salem Steel Plant that was not permitted. Now this is the second attempt Modi government is making. Jindal is very much interested. Adani, Ambani, Reliance, so many people are interested. Say they want to destroy or they want to hand over the entire public sector infrastructure in India to privates. It's a day robbery, it's a looting that should not be allowed. So the working class, not only Tamil Nadu, we have conducted 18 all India agitations since 1991, against the new economic policy to protect the trade union rights, to protect the Indian industry, to protect the domestic industries. We will continue to carry forward that struggle with all vigor and seriousness.
The competitors like Jindal and Tata and other foreign countries are very much eager to buy this plant because of the intellectual capacity of the workers, easy approach by air, easy approach by road and easy railway approach. The company is having an entire established facility of 8 kilometers railway sidings and the nearby Kaveri River water resources and the wealthy Kanjamalai resources. So once the company has been established from the money of people of India and it is being now given in a throwaway price to some individual corporates where the government is having a vested interest.
The Modi government, BJP government, during its tenure one, has adopted a destructive policy towards the public sector undertakings, which were once defined as the modern industrial temples of India. So the public sector undertakings are the backbone of the Indian economic development, industrial development, and for employment generation, and for also providing social justice. The Modi government has declared that almost 24 Balbisita undertakings will be privatized. Against that policy, in 2016, Modi government has declared that Salem Steel Plant, along with Alai Steel Plant Durgapur and Visvesvara Iron and Steel Plant Karnataka, will be put on strategic sale. And the national steel policy says we are going to produce 300 million tons by 2030. Our question is, by 2030, you want to produce 300 million tons with the help of public sector undertakings or with the help of Adani, Ambani, Reliance or SR. Out of 2,300 crores investment, Salem Steel Plant has paid more than 650 crores alone as interest.
The hidden idea behind this paying of interest is to establish this company as a loss-making company. The balance sheet of the company from the year 2015 is in deficit due to the investments. It is quite natural that after any investments in a business, the returns will appear after a period of 6 or 7 years. It is a quite natural phenomenon. And the government has not given enough time to recover from the investments return.
Techno-economic factor என்று சொல்லக்கூடிய தொழில்நுட்ப காரணிகளை செலவுகளை குறைப்பதற்கான காரணிகளை 3 மடங்கு குறைத்திருக்கிறோம். இந்த ஓடக்கூடிய குதிரையைத்தான் இந்த பாஜக அரசு தனியாருக்கு விட்டுவிட தாரை வார்க்க துடிக்கிறது. ஏனென்று சொன்னால் ஸ்டெயின்லெஸ் ஸ்டீல் உற்பத்தியை இந்தியாவிலேயே ஒரே ஒரு பொதுத்துறை நிறுவனம் உலகத்தரம் வாய்ந்த சேலம் உருக்காலை மட்டும்தான். இதற்கு எதிரணியில் இருக்கக்கூடிய போட்டி நிறுவனம் எங்களுடைய தரத்தையும் எங்களுடைய வெரைட்டியையும் சமாளிக்க முடியாமல் இந்த பிராண்டை சேலம் ஸ்டீல் என்ற உலகத்தரம் வாய்ந்த அந்த பிராண்டை முடக்கும் முயற்சியில்தான் இந்த சேலம் உருக்காலையை தனியார் மயமாக்க இந்த பாஜக அரசின் துணையோடு முயன்று கொண்டிருக்கிறது.
The sailors promised to set up a power plant, captive power plant at Salem Steel Plant. So once a captive power plant is set up in Salem Steel Plant, our cost of production will come down because per unit cost of power will come down from 7 rupees 50 paise to 4 rupees 50 paise. So by that we will be able to reduce the cost of production. That project which was sanctioned some 3 years back, is now put on cold storage. And also to improve the marketing of Salem Stainless, some 10 years back, Stainless Steel Special Economic Zone was proposed. The project details were also collected. That project also itself now put in cold storage. So had it been that 300-acre Special Economic Zone was developed and promoted, wherein coach manufacturing unit was also promised, that did not take place. Particularly our major concern is that Salem Stainless was earlier marketed by Salem Steel. Now the marketing has been handed over to Central Marketing Organization. So because of that, the marketing process have been diminished with the lack of manpower. Out of 124 marketing outlets controlled by Central Marketing Organization, only 9 branches, 9 marketing outlets are handling the stainless steel. The Salem Steel Plant was used to conduct the customer meet. We were used to pay more attention for product application and development. So all these things were not taking place now. So the marketing is suffering.
So it seems to be a sabotage by the corporate office, by the ministry, to project this Salem Steel Plant as a negative cash flow area, and by projecting that, they want to hand over this plant to some interested party which they have a vested interest.
And particularly the Modi government, when we are demanding that cheap imports are taking place, particularly from China, South Korea, Indonesia and Japan, we are demanding that minimum support price must be fixed for the import of stainless steel. But that is not taking place because of that lakhs and lakhs of stainless steel is being imported and being dumped at very cheaper prices. So that is affecting the marketing potential of stainless steel. Moreover, the stainless steel industry is also demanding that import duty on stainless steel must be increased from 12.5% to 18%. That is also not taking place. Moreover, the input materials for making of stainless steel, particularly the nickel and the scrap, presently the government of India is levying 2.5% on import duty. So we are also demanding that the import duty on scrap and nickel and also coking coal should be waived. So that will enable Salem plant to improve its marketing. So all these things are not happening.
Salem Steel Plant, after the project capitalization, that means after the payment of interest, is paying off all of its earning in the name of interest. In another span of 2-3 years, the company can overcome the odds.
We are having constraints in the form of interest. We are having constraints in the form of marketing development. So we want the government of India to set up a power plant to reduce our cost of production. Then definitely Salem Steel will be placed on the profit track. Stainless steel is a future metal. And India particularly, there are a lot of growth opportunities. Particularly the per capita consumption in India is 2 kg, whereas the international per capita consumption is 6 kg. So there are a lot of scope and opportunities for the growth of stainless steel industry. And Salem Steel workers are very much agitated. We are already on a series of agitations. So the global tender released by the government of India, August 1 is the date fixed for the bidders to apply. Then 8th August will be the bids will be opened. Last time when Tatas were trying to enter the Salem Steel Plant during Vajpayee period, they were driven out of the premises of Salem Steel Plant. So this time also, if any private players or corporates or MNCs try to enter Salem Steel Plant for the purpose of inspection or with the intention of bidding for Salem Steel Plant, definitely Salem Steel workers will drive them out of the premises of Salem Steel Plant. We are ready to go for any amount of sacrifices. This is a public asset. We will never allow it to be handed over to a private sector.